Sahayam Chustunnadu.
मोबाइल
क्या करते हैं
अरुणोदयानंद कोटि ब्रह्मांडकार शिवादि धरांत तत्व स्वरूपिनो अरुणोदय अनंत कोटि ब्रह्मांडकार शिवादि धरांत तत्व स्वरूपिनो अरुणोदय अनंत कोटि ब्रह्मांडकार शिवादि धरांत तत्व स्वरूपिनो गुरु अन्यम न जायेहम सहस्रदलसरसिज मध्यनिवासिनो सकलचन्द्र भास्करतेज प्रकाशिनो सहस्रदलसरसिज मध्यनिवासिनो सकलचन्द्र भास्कर तेज प्रकाशिनो सहजानंद स्थित दास विश्वासिनो सचित सुखात्मक विश्व विनाशिनो सहजानंद स्थित दास विश्वासिनो सचित सुखात्मक विश्व विनाशिनो अगर स प्रकाश मनोदर विद्या प्रदायक परमात्मनो जग जगद लक्षणय जीवैकात्मनो रह पूजित जीवानन्दनाथात्मनो अगर स प्रकाश मनोदर विद्या प्रदायक परमात्मनो जग जगद लक्षणय जीवैकात्मनो रह पूजित जीवानन्दनाथात्मनो गुरु गुह अन्यम् न जानेऽहं गुप्ताह्यमर्थतत्त्व प्रबोधिनो गुरु गुहात् अन्यं न जानेऽहम्।
प्रणम्य शिरसा देवं गौरीपुत्रं विनायकं प्रणम्य शिरसा देवं गौरीपुत्रं विनायकं भक्तावासं स्मरेन्नित्यम् आयुक्कामार्थसिद्धये प्रथमं वक्रतुण्डंश्च एकदन्तं द्वितीयकम् तृतीयं कृष्णपिङ्गाक्षं गजवक्त्रचतुर्दकम् लम्बोदरं पञ्चमं च षष्ठं विकटमेव च सप्तमं विघ्नराजंश्च धूम्रवर्णं तदाष्टमं नवमं बालचन्द्रंश्च दशमं तु विनायकम् एकादशं गणपतिं द्वादशं तु गजाननम्
महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि महागणपतिं वशिष्ठ वामदेवादिपण्डित महागणपतिं मनसा स्मरामि वशिष्ठ वामदेवादिवन्दित महागणपतिं स्मरामि। महादेवसुतम् महादेवसुतं Kuru Guhanutam Mahadevasutam Kuru Guhanutam Mahadevasutam Kuru Guhanutam Marakoti Prakasham Shantam Mahadevasutam Kuru Guhanutam Marakoti Prakasham Shatam Mahakavya Natakadi Priyam Mahakavya Natakadi Priyam Mushikavahana Modaka Priyam Mahakavya Natakadi Priyam Mushikavahana Modaka Priyam Mahaganapati Mayanasmarami Vashishtavamadevati Mandita Mahaganapatim Smarami
Namaskar. Today being the 245th Janmadinam of Muthuswami Dikshitar, we have taken up Ganapati Krithis of Muthuswami Dikshitar. How Muthuswami Dikshitar has built Ganapati in each Krithi, how insightful he has been in seeing Ganapati in his varied forms, and his description in showing Ganapati and the selection of ragas, the musical, the lyrical, and the historical aspects of Muthuswami Dikshitar will be held briefly in this lecture demonstration. Parabrahman exists in two forms, Nirguna Brahman and Saguna Brahman. The Nirguna Brahman is abstract and we cannot see or feel him. Instead of being him or her, we can call it as it, as there is no gender or there is no attributes that are given to it. The Nirguna Brahman takes a form called Saguna Brahman. The Saguna Brahman is more accessible to the human beings or to the Jivatmas that exist on earth. The Nirguna Brahman forms into Saguna Brahman only because of the karuna it chose on us. Adi Shankara Bhagavad Padad has given us 6 methods of worship called as Shanmatha, in each of which the Saguna Brahman is taken as one form of the Nirguna Brahman. For example, he takes Shakti or Devi and calls it Shaktam. The people following Shaktam or the ones whose Ishta Devata is Shakti can follow the Shakta principles. Similarly, in the same way he has given 5 other forms, which are Ganapatyam, Kaumaram, Shaivam, Vaishnavam, Kaumaram and Savaram. So these principles of Adi Shankara Bhagavad Pada has been strongly followed by Muthuswami Dikshitar. Not only in this Shanmatha aspect, but in his adherence to Advaita philosophy and many other lyrical and historical insights that he gives in his compositions. So the first, and Ganapati doesn't require any introduction to any of our audience here. He is the most celebrated form of Godhead we all know. He is worshipped and propitiated in any form, be it in clay, turmeric, jaggery or even gold. He has various forms, be it Mahaganapati, Nritya Ganapati, Keramba Ganapati or even a Ganapati who is holding a cell phone. We are so affectionately bonded to him that we can't get rid of him, be it what situation it is. Ganapati is the most easiest Godhead to approach, and he gets very easily pleased by the bhakti his devotees show him. So we start this lecture with Muthuswami Dikshitar's birthplace, which is Tiruvallur. Jananath Kamalalaye is what the saying goes. The ones who are born in Tiruvallur are sure to attain salvation. So was Muthuswami Dikshitar, who was born in Tiruvallur. There is a small beautiful shrine that is there outside the temple of Tyagaraja Swami. It is located on the banks of Kamalalayam, where it's a small beautiful shrine which goes unnoticed many times. But Dikshitar takes this into account and composes a very beautiful kriti in Raga Gauda said to Mishra Chapudala. He also quotes the historical references between behind this composition. Sundaramurthy Nayanar, one of the 63 Nayanmars, had one day to Vriddhacharam to have the darshan of Vriddhadineshwara. In the kshetra, he had asked Swami. As he asked, Swami blessed him with some 12,000 gold coins. But Sundaramurthy Nayanar was a bit skeptical and doubtful and was afraid to bring those 12,000 gold coins from Vriddhacharam to Tiruvagur. When he asked Swami, Swami asked him to drop them in the temple pond in Vriddhacharam and asked him to collect it in Tiruvagur. He did the same thing. He came to Tiruvagur, took a dip in Kamalalayam waters and found the 12,000 gold coins there. But Sundaramurthy Nayanar was a bit doubtful whether those gold coins were originally gold or were they artificial or not. So, Tyagaraja Swami, in his, due to his Prabhavam, asked Sundaramurthy Nayanar to confirm it with the Mahaganapati who was sitting on the banks of Kamalalaya. Mahaganapati takes the testing stone and rubs the gold coin and proves Sundaramurthy Nayanar that it is original. Muthuswami Dikshitar very beautifully, very aesthetically quotes it in the charanam, Suvarna Karshana Vigna Rajo. So that is the kriti we are going to listen now. Shri Mahaganapati Avatuma in Gauda Ragam Mishra Chakutalam Tiruvaru Kshetram.
Shri Mahaganapati Avatuma. Shri Mahaganapati Avatuma. Shri Mahaganapati Ravatu Maam Siddhi Vinayako Matanga Mukha Shri Mahaganapati Ravatu Maam Siddhi Vinayako Matanga Mukha Shri Mahaganapati Ravatu Siddhi Vinayako Matanga Mukha Shri Mahaganapati Ravatu Siddhi Vinayako Matanga Mukha Shri Mahaganapati Ravatu Kamajanaka Vidhindra Samputa Kamalalaya Tataniwaso Kamajanaka Vidhindra Samputa Kamalalaya Tataniwaso Komaladara Pallava Padakara Guru Ghagraja Shivayatmaja Komaladara Pallava Padakara Guru Ghagraja Shivayatmaja Shri Maha Ganapati Ravatuma Siddhi Vinayako Matanga Mukha Shri Maha Ganapati Ravatuma. Suvarna Karshana Vignarajo Padambhujo Gaura Varna Vasana Dharo Palachandro Naradi Vinutalam bodharo suvarna ghashana vidhajo padambujo gaura varna vasana dharo phala chandro nanadi vinutalam bodharo kuvalaya swavishana Pasha Pusha Modaka Prakashakaro Bhava Jaladhinamo Muna Prakriti Swabhava Sukhadayaro Kuvalaya Swavishana Pasha Pusha Modaka Prakashakaro Bhava Jaladhinamo Muna Prakriti Swabhava Sukhakaro Ravi Sahasra Sannibhadeho Oh Ravi Sahasra Sannibhadeho Kavi Jananuta Mushikavaho Avanata Devata Samuho Avinashakai Valyadeho Ravi Sahasra Sannibhadeho Kanijananutamushikavaho Avanata Devata Samuho Avinashakai Valyadeho Shri Maha Ganapati Ravatuma Siddhi Vinayako Matangamukha Shri Maha Ganapati Avatuma
There are some more interesting facts about this Krithi. Gaura Varna Vasana Dharo has the Raga Mudra of Gaula. Very typical of Dikshitar. He has a Kshetra Mudra, Raga Mudra, and his Ankita Mudra of Guru Guha in most of his compositions. The Guru Guha Mudra is there in all of his compositions. But the Kshetra Mudra and Raga Mudra are in most of his compositions. Kamalalaya Tatta Viharo indicates Tiruvarur and the literal place where the Ganapati shrine is located. Kamalalayam is just a throne, is a stone's throw away from the shrine. So that is Mahaganapati in Gaula. The next composition we are going to take up is a world famous composition of Dikshitar and has been handled by all musicians. Be it junior artists or senior artists, instrumentalists, who has not taken up this composition in a kacheri, I don't know. So this is the world famous Vatadi Ganapatin in Ragam Hamsadvani set to Aritana. But before we listen to the composition, there are interesting stories, there are many stories behind Vatadi Ganapati. Paranjyoti was a commander-in-chief of this old king. So he had gone to Badami in Karnataka, which was Vatapi, now it is Badami. He had gone there to help the king of Karnataka, and as a gift he got the Vigraham of Vatapi Ganapati. There is one version that tells that he directly established the Vigraham in Tiruvagur. There is another version that tells that he established the Vigraham in Tiruchengattukudi. Why is Tiruchengattukudi in this context? Is Tiruchengattukudi is referred to as the place where Mahaganapati killed the Gajamukhasura. As the Kshetra was filled with blood after the Samharam happened, it is called Tiruchengattukudi. Chengattukudi refers to the red color place. So the blood was filled with blood, so that is called Tiruchengattukudi. So one version tells that Paranjyoti installed it in Tiruchengattukudi. Another version tells that he installed it in Tiruvarur directly. But before Vatapi Ganapati came to Tiruvarur, he was in Karnataka, as I already told. But how he came to Karnataka is another story. Dikshitar very beautifully tells this also in the Krithi. Vatapi Ganapati was originally installed by Agastya. We all know Agastya is a great Maharishi who has not left any godhead unworshipped. So he tells Pura Kumbha Sambhava Munivara Prabhujitam. Kumbhava. Kumbhava. Pura Kumbhava Sambhava. Agastya is supposed to have been born from a kumbha. So he refers to Agastya in the first line of his charanam. That's a very beautiful anecdote related to Adabi Ganapati. Another beautiful thing about this is the ragam itself, which is Hamsadvani. Hamsadvani is a ragam, most of them would have been knowing, created by Muthuswamy Dikshitar's father, Ramaswamy Dikshitar. Initially, he did not have the intent of creating Krithis or dedicating it to Ganapati or something. Only after this Vatabi Ganapati happened, future composers, post-Trinity composers made all compositions in Hamsadvani as dedication to Ganapati. He did a Prabandham on Nataraja in Chidambaram. But then after seeing this Vatabi Ganapati as a magnum opus, all other Bhagyakaras that came in the post-Trinity period made compositions dedicating it to Ganapati. Be it Papanasam, Shivan, or many other composers created compositions in praise of Ganapati. Another very interesting factor, there are many other interesting factors, I will tell one by one. He tells Mooladhara Kshetrasthitam in the Charanam. Mooladhara Kshetrasthitam can be seen in many different aspects. One refers to Tiruvarur directly. Tiruvarur is also called as Mooladhara Kshetram. So Ganapati is Vatabi. So it can be taken in that aspect. If we think one step ahead, one step more than that, Ganapati is supposed to reside in the Mooladhara Chakram in our body, out of the Shat Chakras. So in furthermore, Krithi is also the same reference Dikshitar quotes. So Mooladhara Kshetrasthitam also refers to Mooladhara Chakram, where Ganapati resides and blesses the devotees. So that is one very beautiful thing. And another is Pranavasvarupa Vakratundam. When musicians nowadays we sing, we tell Mooladhara Kshetrasthitam, and then we tell Paragi Chatvari Vakatmakam. We leave a gap and then we tell Pranavasvarupa Vakratundam. It was not there originally like that. It was Paragi Chatvari Vakatmaka Pranavasvarupa Vakratundam. There was not gap, there was not so much gap in between those two lines. Why was it like that? Is a very beautiful thing that should be taught and it should be enjoyed by everybody. Paradi Chatvari Vak. There are four forms of Vak, or four forms of how sound emanates in a human body. There are four levels that is usually found, that happens in every human body. First form of Vak is Para. Then it becomes Pashyati. Then it becomes Madhyama, and when we talk, it comes out of words as Vahikari. This finds reference in Dalita Sahasranama as Para Pratyakchiti Rupa Pashyanti Paradevata Madhyama Vahikari Rupa Bhakta Manasa Kamsika. So there is another reference where Dikshitar tells Ganapati is not only Ganapati that we see. He again proves a Shanmata principle of Adi Shankara again in Vatabi Ganapati. We have only enjoyed Vatabi Ganapati as a famous tune that is played in the beginning of concerts. But we have never paid, I don't think we pay so much attention to detail. And that when he gives, there is no much gap between Paradi Chatvari Vakatmaka Pranavasvarupa Vakratundam. Why is there no gap? Is that Pranavakaram originates in the Paravak that emanates from the Mooladhara Chakram. It originates so brilliantly, so much effulgence, so much prakasha that it fills the human body, it fills the sadhaka or the worshipper with so much energy that he himself becomes a swarupa of Ganapati in fact. This is how Dikshitar was. Dikshitar imbibed the qualities, not just the physical, but also the esoteric qualities of the Upasana Murti he was involved with. That is the main reason why he used Pranavasvarupa Vakratundam. And there are other important things. Nithila Chandra Kandam. Dikshitar here very beautifully tells who Ganapati's parents are and how a child imbibes the qualities of both his mother and father. Nithila Chandra Kattam, you know, Chandra Munishwara as Shiva. So Ganapati bears the crescent moon like how his father does. And Trikona Madhya Kattam like how his mother does. Kabadamba or Mahatripura Sundari resides within the triangle. So he also resides within the triangle like how his mother does, and he bears the crescent moon like his father does. So he's a combination of the Shiva Shakti Swarupam, is what Dikshitar tells here. And he tells in further compositions also. He likes to repeat a few concepts so much that we get involved in that. I think Dikshitar believes in the power of repetition or japa, as we call it. And Karambujapasha Bijapuram, again he goes back to Mahaganapati Dhyanam. It doesn't refer to the direct iconography of the Vigraham. The Vatavi Ganapati Vigraham that we see in Tiruvarur doesn't have Bijapura or the pomegranate in his hand. He doesn't have Ikshudantam, he doesn't have sugar cane in his hand. He is the usual Chaturbhuja Ganapati that we see in temples. But this Karambujam, this beautiful aspects, this few minor details Dikshitar tells, doesn't refer to the literal iconographic details of the Vigraham, but more of the internal sadhana Dikshitar has done to visualize Ganapati in his beautiful Mahaganapati form. And then the last line is where the bliss lies. Hamsa Dhvani Bhushita Herangam. This also can be seen in two aspects. One is a literal aspect, and another is where you do a lot of thinking and go into the depths of the raga or the sahitya. Hamsa Dhvani Bhushita Herambam, on a very broad view, can be seen as Ganapati is satisfied, very happy when we sing the Hamsa Dhvani Raga. Hamsa Dhvani Bhushita Herambam. Ganapati wears Hamsa Dhvani Raga as a bhushanam or as an ornament, and he is very happy about it. He is very blissful about it. But on a very deep, in a very deeper context, when we see Hamsa Dhvani, as Ramaswami Dikshitar has created, doesn't refer to just a raga here, but the very essence of Tiruvarur Tyagaraja has been reflected in the last line. The Ajapa Natanam or the Hamsa Natanam, as Hamsa Mantram, the essence of Hamsa Mantram or the Ajapa Mantram is what Dikshitar shows in the last line, Hamsa Dhvani Bhushita Herambam. That mantram doesn't have, it is a very beautiful aspect that cannot be discussed in public. It is a very beautiful upasana niti or that should be obtained from a guru, but it doesn't have a physical, that cannot be given a physical form. That is what is the whole essence of Tiruvarur, and Dikshitar again and again and again and again repeats the same concept throughout all of his Tiruvarur Krithis also in general. Not only in Ganapati Krithis, but also in his Nilotpanamba Krithis, Tyagaraja Krithis, Kamalambanamba Vannams, any Krithi related to Tiruvarur, he very strongly holds on to this concept. With that being said, let us listen to the Vatavi Ganapati that is sung nowadays. Then we will listen to the...
You'll do the Pallavi in the Sangeeta Sampradaya.
Sampradaya Pradashini
version.
Version.
From there, the Anupalavi and the Charanam would follow into the concert format that
yeah.
we have today.
Vatapi Ganapatim Bhaje Ham Vatapi Ganapatim Bhaje Ham Varanasyam Vada Pratam Shri Varanasyam Vada Pratam Shri Vatapi Ganapatim Bhaje Hum. Bhutadi Samsevita Charanam Bhutadi Samsevita Charanam Bhuta Bhautika Prapancha Bharanam Bhutadi Samsevita Charanam Bhuta Bhautika Prapancha Bharanam Vitarakinam Vinutayoginam Vitaraginam Vinutayoginam Vishwakaranam Vignavaranam Vitaraginam Vinutayoginam Vishwakaranam Vignavaranam Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham Varanasyam Varadam Shri Vatapi Ganapati Bhajeham.
Sorry for the interruption, but you can see a stark difference between the Pallavi and the Anupallavi he sang. There's a very beautiful anecdote that they came across and I want to share with the audience here. The Pallavi that he sang is as per the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradashini or the very formal documentation of Dikshitar's works which were done by Ramaswamy, which were done by Subbarama Dikshitar. So in his version, Vatapi Ganapatim, the Kriti goes in a very chaukakala, very slow moving format without much of sangatis. The beauty of the Sahitya is not destroyed. Whereas, after a few years, in the same Samakala, there was another very big Bhagyakara called Mahavaidyanatha Shivan. His 72 Melaraga Malika is very famous as we all know. He wanted to get creative and he added sankatis as how he had sang the Anupallavi. And the second time he sang the Pallavi. He added many sankatis and after listening to this version of Vatapi Ganapatim, Dikshitar's descendants got very angry about it. They got very offended by how this the original version has been spoiled and ruined. And Subbarama Dikshitar even went to the extent of removing Mahavaidyanatha Shivan's history from the Bhagyakara Charitra, means Sampradaya Pradashini. So that is the extent. Now everybody, even I have learned Vatapi Ganapatim only in the fast moving Mahavaidyanatha Kacheri format. Now all of us sing only Mahavaidyanatha Shivan's version of Vatapi Ganapatim. Now very few of us go to the roots and sing the original version of Vatapi Ganapatim. It is very difficult to learn and sing that Vatapi Ganapatim because we are so used to sing steppy Kacheri format of Vatapi Ganapatim, which is laden with sangatis and which is fast moving and keeps audience glued to the artist who is singing. So let's move on to the charanam.
Pura Kumbha Sambhava Munivara Prapujitam Trikona Madhyagatam Pura Kumbha Sambhava Munivara Prapujitam Trikona Madhyagatam Murari Pramukhadupasitam Muladhara Kshetra Sthitam Murari Pramukhadupasitam Muladhara Kshetra Sthitam Paradvi Chatvari Vagatmakam Pranava Swarupa Vakratundam Paradvi Chatvari Vagatmakam Pranava Swarupa Vakratundam Nirantaram Nithila Chandra Kandam Nijavamakara Vidhutekshutam Karabucha Pasha Bija Puram Karusha Viduram Bhutalakaram Karabucha Pasha Bija Puram Karusha Viduram Bhutalakaram Haradi Guru Vadoshita Bimba Hamsadhwani Bhushita Heram Bhamvata Karabuja Pasha Bija Puram Karusha Viduram Bhutakaram Haradi Guru Vadoshita Bimba Hamsadhwani Bhushita Heram Vadapi Ganapati Bhajeham Varanasyam Varadam Shri Vadapi Ganapati Bhajeham.
The next piece is a very beautiful composition of Dikshitar. When we think of Ganapati or not Ganesha, one festival that comes into everybody's mind is Pillayar Chaturthi, Vinayaka Chaturthi or Ganesh Chaturthi. Dikshitar very beautifully, very aptly, to the pin, he describes this festival, its grandeur, how it was celebrated in his times in the Chamaram Kriti Siddhi Vinayakam. Why did he use Siddhi Vinayakam to address Ganapati? It's a very beautiful thing that we need to know. In any of our old texts or puja materials that we have, Ganapati is referred to as Siddhi Vinayaka during the Ganapati Puja, during Ganesh Chaturthi. He is not referred to as Mahaganapati. He is not referred to as any other forms of Ganapati that we know, but he is referred to as only Siddhi Vinayaka during the Puja. In fact, the Puja itself is called as Varasiddhi Vinayaka Pratam. And Dikshitar, very beautifully, nobody else but Dikshitar can incorporate such details into compositions. So, many of them would have known this composition, but Charanam has beautiful details about this composition. He goes to tell Bhadrapada Masa Chaturthiyam, the fourth day of Bhadrapada Masa, or the fourth day after Amavasya of Bhadrapada Masa, this puja is done. Usually, Sankatahara Chaturthi is done the fourth day after Paurnami. But this Chaturthi comes in the reverse order. It is the fourth day after Amavasya. So that Dikshitar doesn't, it will very subtly he describes that Bhadrapada Masa Chaturthiyam Brahmanadi Pujitam. Why did he tell Brahmanadi was the casteist? No. Then why did he tell that? He was not a casteist. We will see why he was not a casteist in upcoming compositions. Brahmanadi Pujitam, because the Ganapati Homam that was done in those days, or is being done now, can be done only, was usually done only by Brahmins, or Dvijas as they are usually called. That's it, Brahmanadi Pujitam. Brahmins also worship him, but most of the Brahmins only perform this Varasiddhi Nayakam Pratam on a grander scale. So that's why he refers this not to insult other people, but also to put forth the fact. Pashang Kushadharam. Here he is not Mahaganapati, he is not in a very extraordinary position at all. He is one amongst us. He is like a friend to us. He is only having Pashang Kushadharam. Chatra Chamara Paridejitam. Or Parivajitam, however your pardon is. Why Chatra Chamara? Here Chatra Chamara Parivajitam has also the Ragamudra, Chamaram. He refers to the puja paraphernalia that is used during the puja. Chatra is the umbrella and Chamara is a fan that is used in the Shodasopachara Puja. Why Chatra? Because whenever we do the Pillayar Chaturthi Puja, we usually buy the Pillayar Kodai. It is a very beautiful custom where children either make the umbrella or go to the market and specially buy the umbrella. Maybe he would have referred to that in this composition. Just a small thought. Chamara Parivejitam, because Ganapati likes to be flanked and pampered, Chatra Chamara Parivejitam. And here comes the very beautiful aspect. Rauhineya Rujachitam. If we pronounce this word wrongly, it becomes Rohineya Rujachitam. That gives a totally different meaning. Rohini is one of the nakshatrams that we know, and is the most dear nakshatram to Chandram. So, Dikshitar very beautifully talks about human mentality and human psychology. If someone tells us not to do one particular thing, we aptly do it. So, on Pillayar Chaturthi, we are not supposed to have Chandra Darsanam. So, he knows that we might pronounce this word wrongly. So, that's why he has said, Rauhineya Ujarchitam. Where if we tell Rauhini, we might think of Chandran and we might go and have Chandra Darsanam. He is telling, don't have Chandra Darsanam. Think of Rauhineya Rujachitam. This Rohini, who is this Rohini? We need to go back to the Charitram of Krishna or Bhagavatam, where Rohini's son's brother has worshipped Krishna. Who is Rohini's son? Rohini's son is Balarama. Anujam is Balarama's younger brother. Balarama's younger brother is Krishna. Krishna has worshipped Ganapati. Why did Krishna worship Ganapati? That is a story, or that is a Phadastuti that we usually chant or read after the Pillayar Puja is over on the day of Ganesh Chaturthi, Pillayar Chaturthi. That is the story of Shamantaka Mani. Because Krishna lost the Shamantaka Mani, he was filled with tapa. He was having a sense of suffering within him because he lost that money, that gemstone. In order to overcome that suffering, Narada Muni advised him to perform the Siddhivinayaka Vratam by making a vigraham out of mud or mrittika bimba. That is also one of the reasons why we perform Siddhivinayaka Vratam, and chanting or reading this story on the day of Siddhivinayaka Vratam will reduce all the sins or tapams or sufferings that we face in our daily lives. And Dikshitar, in other verses, it is very self-explanatory. I don't think it is necessary to go into it. You will directly go into designing this beautiful Chamaram Kriti in Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham Chintayamyakam.
Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham Chintayamyakam Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham Chintayamyaham Prasiddha Gananayakam Vishishthadhanayakam Varam Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham Chintayamyaham Prasiddha Gananayakam Vishishthadhanayakam Varam Siddhi Divinayakam. Siddha Yaksha Kinnaradi Sevitam. Siddha Yaksha Kinnaradi Sevitam Akhila Jagat Prasiddha Yaksha Kinnaradi Sevitam Akhila Jagat Prasiddha Mula Pankajam Madhyastam Modakastam Siddha Yaksha Kinnaradi Sevitam Akhila Jagat Prasiddha Dhamula Pankajam Madhyastham Modakastham Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham. Bhadrapada Masa Chaturthyam Ramanadi Pujitam Bhadrapada Masa Chaturthyam Ramanadi Pujitam Pashankushadharam Chatrachamara Parivijitam Pashankushadharam Chatrachamara Parivijitam Raudra Bhavarahitam Dasajana Hridaya Virajitam Raudra Bhavarahitam Dasajana Hridaya Virajitam Rauhine Yanujachitam Ihana Vajitam Rauhine Yanujachitam Ihana Vajitam Atri Raja Sutatmajam Ananta Guru Guhagrajam Atri Raja Sutatmajam Ananta Guru Guhagrajam Bhadra Pradapadambujam Bhasamana Chaturbhujam Bhadra Pradapadambujam Bhasamana Chaturbhujam Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham. Atri Raja Suta Bajam Ananta Guru Guhagrajam Bhadra Pradapadambujam Bhasamana Chaturbhujam Siddhi Vinayakam Manishan Chintayamyam Prasiddha Gananayakam Vishishtadhanayakam Param Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham Anisham.
Before we move on to the next composition, you also find reference to navy idioms that is made in this festival as Modaka Hastam in the Anupallavi, and also Moola Pankaja Madhyastam as reference to the Mooladhara Chakram as Moola Pankajam. It is Mooladhara Chakram is also referred to as a lotus. So lotus is Pankajam. Dikshitar calls it as Moola Pankaja Madhyastam. Modaka Hastam Siddhi Vinayakam. So we know that Dikshitar was an amazing traveler. He went on to various kshetrams singing on deities of the kshetram. He has also sung on specific Ganapati shrines in many kshetrams, out of which we will be doing a few. So the first kshetram we have taken is Madurai. There are very clear references to Madurai in this Kriti. The Kriti we have taken is Ekadantam Bhajeham. He tells Ekadantam Bhajeham, which itself is a very beautiful way of addressing. There is a beautiful reason for that. The beauty of an elephant, treasure called Mahabharata, Ganapati went on to break his tusk, not minding his physical appearance. He did not bother how I will look after my tusk. We call him Ekadanta without just for the sake of calling, but we should think of the thought that went behind Dikshitar, who started the Kriti with Ekadantam Bhajeham. And interestingly, Madurai happens to be a seat for literature. So Mahabharata is also a piece of literature, and Ekadantam Bhajeham also refers to how Mahaganapati has contributed to literature by breaking his tusk and writing Mahabharata. This shows how much karuna the Parat Brahman has on us. And then he moves on to tell Eka Aneka Phalapratham. He could have directly told Aneka Phalapratham. Why did he tell Eka Aneka? Aneka Phalapratham means the one who grants us many boons. Why did he tell the one who grants one and many boons? Many boons also includes one boon. But he didn't tell that way. He told one and many boons. He also grants us one boon. He also grants us many boons. But I don't think that should be interpreted in that way. Eka Aneka Phalapratham. Eka Phalapratham refers to that one-minded focus that all of us should have, which is moksha or sayujya. He refers to that Eka Phalapratham. Aneka Phalapratham refers to all other materialistic benefits that we ask Ganapati. So Ganapati is capable and talented in giving us both bhoga, that is necessary to live in this world comfortably, and moksha, that is required to attain his holy feet. He doesn't compose just for the sake of composing. There is so much thought, so much attention to detail. Each akshara has so much detailing that we cannot even imagine of composing a piece that can be equalized with this. In Anupallavi, there is another beautiful phrase that can be related to the Siddhi Vinayakam we sang before. Pamara Panditadi Nuta Padam. This we'll keep aside and we'll go back to Siddhi Vinayakam, where we told Brahmanadi Pujitam. Dikshitar there tells Ganapati is worshipped by Brahmins as well. Okay, Brahmins as well. Here he tells Pamara Panditadi Nutam. Pamara refers to the uneducated, the illiterate, normal human beings like us. Panditas are referred to as scholars, the one who is well versed in Vedas, Upanishad, Shastras, the one who has attained Atma, who has seen, who has attained self-realization, can be seen as Panditas. So Ganapati is worshipped by both Pamaras and Panditas. That is one aspect. Another aspect is both Pamaras and Panditas are equal in the eyes of Ganapati. He doesn't show any difference just because we are a Pandita or a Pamara. He knows what to give his devotees and when to give his devotees and how to give his devotees. How was Dikshitar blessed? Shouldn't we go back and see? Was Dikshitar well versed with Vilakari and Chamaram? Or with Maya Madhava Gowda before he composed his first piece? Nobody knows. It was only because of that divine grace that happened at Kirtani that Amritam started flowing out of his mouth. Or how did he get the Veena? It is all that divine grace that happens at that spot. That divine knows what to give, how to give, and when to give. Dikshitar refers to many such instances very subtly, very beautifully, yet very strongly. It is subtle, yet it is strong. That is the talent of Dikshitar. That is where he is Nipunaha. How Dikshitar loves to use that word Nipunaha. Dikshitar is also Nipunaha in using such things, in handling such things. In Charanam, he tells, Kailasanatha Kumaram. He reminds, constantly tells, don't move away, this is Madurai. When we sing or listen to this Kriti, we usually listen with the mindset that this is a Ganapati Kriti. But Dikshitar constantly reminds us, this is a Ganapati Kriti, yes, but this is Madurai Kshetra Kriti, please remember. That's why Kailasanatha Kumaram, he subtly refers to Somasundareshwara Swami there. So Kailasanatha Kumaram, Karthikeya Manoharam. Just beside Madurai, we have Murugan Kshetrams. We have out of Arubadai Veedu, we have two Veedu just beside Madurai. So, Karthikeya Manoharam. Now comes the stamp of Madurai. Halasya Kshetra. Begavati Tata Viharam. Madurai is very beautifully refers to as Halasya in many of the. Even Halasya Natham. In Darbar, Dikshitar called Somasundareshwara, or in Madurambha Vibhakti also there are differences. So Halasya Kshetra is one. And Vegavati Tata Viharam. Dikshitar loves lakes and rivers. In Kanti Matim also he tells Shuddha Tamra Parani Tatasthitam. In Abhayambha Vibhakti he tells Kaveri Tatasthitam. Dundi Vinaya Kaveri. In Karikadava Mukham he tells Kaveri Tatasthitam. Then in Kasi Kshetrams, he has composed a Kriti on Ganga itself, on Gange Mampahi.
Kamalalaya
Thirtha Vaibhave. That we need not ask in each of the Kamala Manava Varnam Swatirvaru Kshetra Kritis. Kamalalaya, he loves, he has obsession towards Kamalalaya. So water bodies seem to be a favorite for Dikshitar as much as Raga Mudra or any other things seem to be for him. Then we move on to see Kola Hala Guru Guha Sahitam. Another beautiful reference to Madurai. He has used the word Kola Hala. Madurai is also called Tunga Nagaram. Not because of the Veeram or something like that, but because Madurai is Nityotsava place, Kshetramship. There are Utsavams taking place every month. Not even a single month is there without Utsavams to Meenakshi Sundareshwara.
Other than this coronavirus.
Other than this virus thing. But even then, Meenakshi and Sundareshwara are experiencing Utsavam in their own bliss. We do not know how they are having their blissful time. Kolahala Guru Guha Sahitam. So, Ganapati is happy in experiencing that excitement, that kolahalam with which the residents of Madurai are happy and excited about each Utsavam that comes up. Even though the Utsavam comes up every month, the excitement amongst the residents of Madurai is never going down. It is only increasing day by day. Kotil Mara Lavanya Hitam. Hitam refers to be handsome or looking beautiful. He is as beautiful as a Mara or a Manmatha. Not one Manmatha, not two Manmathas, not even 100 Manmathas. Koti Manmathas. Here Koti shouldn't be taken as 1 crore. but as innumerable manmathas. Even if innumerable manmathas stand in front of Ganapati, their beauty cannot be matched to one Ganapati. Then, Mala Kankanadi Dharanam. As much as Sundareshwara loves to be decked with Abharanas, so does the Ganapati in Madurai loves to be decked. Mala Kankanadi Dharanam. Masha Vallabhamba Ramanam. Or people call it Maya Vallabhamba Ramanam. The Masha or Maya. The concept is the same. He has the goddess Vallabhamba sitting on his lap. So Dikshitar refers to that goddess who is always accompanying Ganapati and blessing his devotees. This also has deeper connotations which will be handled in upcoming compositions. Now let's listen to Ekadantam Bhajeham Raga Vidahari Kadam Mishra Chapu.
Just a minute. So we are also having a live going on Insta. So I just got to just click the like there as well.
Ekadantam bhajeham ekaneka phalapratam ekadantam bhajeham ekaneka phalapratam ekadantam bhajeham ekaneka phalapratam ekadantam bhaje. Pākaśāsanāradhitam pāmara paṇḍita dinutapadam pākaśāsanāradhitam pāmara paṇḍita dinutapadam pākaśāsanāradhitam pāmara paṇḍita dinutapadam ekadantam bhajeham. Kailasanathakumaram Kartikeya Manoharam Kailasanathakumaram Kartikeya Manoharam Halasya Vegavati Tataviharam Halasya Kshetra Vedayavati Tataviharam Haram Kolala Guru Guha Saitam Koti Marala Vanyayitam Kolala Guru Guha Saitam Koti Marala Vanyayitam Mala Kankanadi Dharanam Masha Vallabha Maravanam Ekadantam Kolala Guru Guha Saitam Koti Marala Vanyayitam Mala Kankanadi Dharanam Masha Vallabha Maravanam Ekadantam Bhajeham Ekadaneka Phalapratam Ekadantam Bhajeham.
Mm-hmm. next kshetram is Vaidheeshwaran Kovil. Very beautiful kshetram. A kshetram for Ankarakan as well. Today being a Tuesday is another important beautiful aspect that we are even talking about Mahaganapati. It is a kshetram for Ankarakan, and Dikshitar in his Ankarakam Ashrayami also quotes references to Vaidheeshwaran Kovil or Vaidhyanatha Kshetram. So Dikshitar in his composition Shri Ganeshat Param, in a very beautiful raga, I don't think there is any other composition in this raga as of my limited knowledge. It is in the raga Ardra Deshi. It is said to the fifth Vibhakti. Vibhaktis is another beautiful aspect. It's another aspect Dikshitar tightly holds on to. Be it any composition, there is some or other Vibhakti that can be properly fit into. There is not even one composition other than the Kamalamba 9th Avarna, where there is Dikshitar lists out the whole of the 8 Vibhaktis. There is no other composition as of my knowledge where Dikshitar mixes up 2-3 Vibhaktis or...
Yes. So in compositions like Sri Varalakshmi,
yeah,
it has got the Sambodhana and the 4th Vibhakti. So a few compositions,
there are a few compositions, but most of them can be perfectly fit into one a particular Vibhakti format, and it is very easy. Why has this? Because of this aspect of Dikshitar, it is very easy for even Sanskrit students to understand the language as well. The beauty of language, be it the prasam. How can I not stop talking from prasam? Stop talking myself about prasam. The dvitiyakshara prasam, antakshara prasam.
Yes.
We have played Antakshari yesterday, day before yesterday, and all over Instagram. Dikshitar would have overruled us if he was there with his prasams and all. So now I will make a humble attempt of singing Ardra Deshi. I have tried learning the Kriti in the past 4-5 days. So it's just a humble attempt of singing Ardra Deshi.
Shri Ganeshat Padam Chetra Nahi Re. Shri Ganeshat Padam Chetra Nahi Re. Shivadi Shatrim Shatattva Swarupina Shri Ganeshat Padam Chita Nahi Re. Vagadi Panchaka Vyapara Rahita Hridaya Kasha Samstita Yogi Dajachita. Shri Ganeshat Padam Chita Nahi Re. Shivadi Shatrimshat Tattva Swarupina Shri Ganeshat Padam Chita Nahi Re. Matanga Vadana Mahudra Dashitat Matanga Badanat Mahudra Dashitat Bhuta Bhautika Vishva Pujita Kalevara Shvetarga Sumanharat Svetara Vivajitat Pitambaravatat Brahma Dhruvasitat Bhutadi Bhutavadam Bhojat Bhutadhinutabhadam Bhojat Shivatmajat Shidam Chodara Paramashiva Guru Bhuvagrajat Shri Ganeshatpadam cheta nahire Bhutadinuta padam bhoja shiva maja Chetam shudara paramashiva guru agraja shi Ganeshatpadam cheta nahire Shivadi shatrinshat tattva swarupina shi Ganeshatpadam chitta nahi.
This is a very beautiful composition on Vaidheshwaran Kovil, as you already told. There are two Ganapati Sannadhis in Vaidheshwaran Kovil. One in the outer prakaram and another in the inner prakaram. We do not have enough evidence to prove on which Ganapati Sannadhi this is originally composed on. But this is composed on Vaidheshwaran Kovil is what the Sampradaya Pradashini and other books tell us. The beauty of Ardra Deshi, the Raga Mudra, is the most beautiful aspect in this composition. Before I tell where the Raga Mudra lies, we have to go back to the Sahasranama, Lalita Sahasranama. There are two Namavalis, two consecutive Namavalis that talks about Mahaganapati in Lalita Sahasranama. One is Kameshwara Mukhaloka Kalpita Shri Ganeshwara. Immediately the next one is Mahaganesha Nirbhinna Vigna Yantra Praharshita. Here, the genesis of Mahaganapati is given. So does the Lalita Sahasranama also tells us how Mahaganapati was born. Here also, Dikshitar reflects the same ideology. Devi, as Mahatripura Sundari, goes to the battlefield to fight with Bhandasura. This comes as a part of the Bhandasura Vadam or Yuddham. The Bhandasura puts a yantram or an obstacle called Vigna Yantram. And all the army of Lalitamba are tired and faint and fall down. Lalitamba knows what to do and she gently looks and smiles at Mahakameshwara. Just because of that smile and look, Mahaganapati was born, says the Lalita Sahasranama. Kameshwara Mukhaloka Kalpita Shri Ganeshwara. Mahaganapati was born or Kalpita out of that gentle glance and smile of Mahatripura Sundari and Mahakameshwara. Here, Dikshitar in the first line of Charanam tells Matanga Vadanath, the elephant headed god, was born as a result of Uma Rudra Darshitat. Uma and Rudra saw each other and he was born. The same ideology is reflected, isn't it? And so the Raga Mudra is very beautifully inserted in Uma
Matanga
Badana Uma Rudra Darshita Uma Rudra Darshita Arudra Darshita Arudra Darshita Ardra Deshi.
That's how Dikshitar has inserted the Raga Mudra so much to give us, you know, there is so much for us to think and imbibe from this composition. Not only this, there are many such compositions where Raga Mudra is so beautifully interwoven into the lyrics. Another example is Parimala Ranganatha. Can you sing?
Parimala Ranganatham Bhajeham Veera Nutam Paripanita Bhattam Pum Sundarika Vallina Adham Parimala Ranganatham Bhajeham Veera
Bhajeham Veera Nutam. When the both the words join, it becomes Ham Veera Nutam. That is where Hamir Kalyani is reflected there. Am I right?
Ham Veera Hamira.
There are two more beautiful things that Dikshitar tells in this composition. Shvetarka Sumadharat Svetara Divarjitat. It's very important to tell these words clearly and distinctively, if not, it will sound very wrongly. Shvetarka refers to the Vellirukkambu or the flowers that is dear to Ganapati and offered during Kalya Chaturthi and other pujas. It is also dear to Lord Shiva. That's why maybe he has referred to Shiva many times in this Kriti. He calls him Paramashiva Guru Guha Grajad and Uma Rudra Darshitat. Maybe it is because of the flower connection also. He brings in the flower also. Maybe because it is because of the Shiva Parvati, Shiva Shakti Aikyam that Ganapati was born. He refers so much to Shiva here.
Temple being
Vaidishwaran Kovil. It is Ishwaran Kovil, Vaidishwaran Kovil. Again Shiva comes there. And that flower is also referred to here. Ganapati is very pleased, very happy when he is offered Shweta Arka flowers, Arka Pushpam. And Swetara Divarjitat. Swetara is a very important and a very serious concept in Advaita. In higher stages of Advaita, when self-realization happens, Swayatara is something that every individual gets to know on their own by the grace of the Divine. Dikshitar very beautifully refers to that here. Pitambaradhara, Dikshitar here describes Ganapati as wearing yellow color ornaments or yellow color vastra. Before we move to the next composition, there is another important, very important thing that Dikshitar refers here, the Pallavi. Shivadi Shatrimshat Tattvas Varupinaha. There are 36 tattvas in Shakta philosophy. As you all know, Dikshitar was a Parama Shakta, very strong Shakta and a Sri Vidya Upasaka. Despite which Godhead he is describing, he brings in the concept of Sri Vidya somehow or the other, be it directly or indirectly, somehow he thinks. Even when he is singing Krishna in Mannarguri, he calls him Sri Vidya Rajagopalam Bhajeham. He doesn't, even though he addresses him as Putanati Simharam Incheta Sri Balakrishnam or Balagopala, completely with reference to Bhagavatam, in Balagopala and Vaidevi, again he calls him as Vainika Gayaka Guru Puhanuta. Again, the Vainika Gayaka, there are many other deeper concepts that we will discuss in another concept, in another lecture demonstration maybe. But here, as I already told, whichever Godhead he describes, he brings in the Shakta philosophies effortlessly. I don't think he would have put so much thought in such things. Sometimes I feel he would have put thought. Sometimes I feel he wouldn't have put thought. Only Dikshitar should have come and explained these things to us. How much ever we try to explain, I don't think there will be a suitable explanation as much as Dikshitar can do to his own compositions. So this refers to the 36 tattvas, and again the same 36 tattvas Dikshitar quotes in the Kamalamba Navavarana Kriti, in the 5th Bhairavi Avarana Kriti. Can you sing the Pallavi?
Shri Kamalamba Ya param nahi re re chit kshitya adi sa kshitya adi shivam ta ta tvara swarupinya shri kamala vaya param nahi re re chitta kshitya.
You can see so much of similarity. There also is the fifth avaranam, fifth vibhakti. Here also is the fifth vibhakti. There he tells Shivadi.
Shivadi. Shivata tatva swarupinyaha.
Shityadi Shivanta tatva swarupinyaha. Kshiti refers to earth. That's why we have also have another Dikshitar composition. Kshitija Ramanam. Kshitija, the daughter of the earth, is Sita. Ramanam, her husband, refers to Rama. That's another composition. Kshiti, from Kshiti to Shiva, in all the tattvas, it is only the Kamadamba who will prevail in all. That is pure Shaktam, pure Srimidya. Here it is pure Ganapati, pure Ganapatyam. He compares Ganapati and Kamadamba almost on the same platform, again referring to, again taking inspiration from Adi Shankaracharya. Same that the six principles that Adi Shankaracharya used, Shanmatha. Adi Shankaracharya or all the Pithadipatis who come in the lineage of Adi Shankara, be it either Kanchi Kamakoti Pitam. Or Shringeri Acharyas always have the love for the Namavali, Shanmata Stapaka Acharya in Namo Namaha. When you do Archana for Adi Shankara Acharya, that Namavali has some special love from all the Acharyas. And so do they love Dikshitar. Now, I think we are able to find some link where all these goes up. Next is another kshetram near Tanjavur, where Ganapati is not seen in a proper vigraham form, but he is established by Indra, is consecrated by Indra, not in a vigraham, not in stone, not in metal, not in clay, not in turmeric, but with froth. Froth as in the white bubbly froth that we see, that from an ocean. Mara that we tell in English, or Fena that we tell in Sanskrit. Fena or Pena. Why did Indra do this? There was an Asura who fought with Indra. And Indra was helpless at that place. And Mahavishnu ordered Indra to worship Mahaganapati amidst the ocean. Where will Indra go for puja materials there? So he immediately saw the froth, he made a vigraham there, and he did puja to Mahaganapati. That form can be now seen in Tanjavur Kumbakonam, that district. Dikshitar has not clearly told which place is this. But as per the description in this Kriti, we can come to a conclusion that it is in that kshetra.
So, I think I have been to this temple because we have been travelling towards Tanjavur and the Tiruvayar kshetra. So, when we were all travelling with our Guru, we went to the Shwetagadavi temple. It is very close by to the Swami Malai temple.
Yes, it is very near by to Swami Malai. So, Dikshitar, this is another very rare yet very beautiful ragam, Chudamani. It is referred to as Chudamani sometimes. Few times as Raga Chudamani, because Raga is Chudamani. What should be appreciated is here is the way Dikshitar has inserted the Raga Mudra. Here again I will be rendering this Kriti. I have just tried to learn this Kriti in the past 4-5 days. So it's again a very humble attempt to sing this Kriti. ragam raga chudamani triputadar.
Shveta Ganapatim Twamadeva Pratipadyamanadyam Shveta Ganapatim Twamadeva Pratipadyamanadyam Shveta Ganapatim Vande Bhuta Ganadi Samsevitam Buddha Guru Guha Sambhavitam Matangamukam Vallabha Sametam Viraga Chudamani Matangamukam Vallabha Sametam Viraga Chudamani Shweta Ganapati Vamadeva Pratipadyamanadhyam Shweta Ganapati
With reference to the Sampurna Padati that we are following in today's parlance, this will become the 32nd Mayalakarta or the 32nd Raga Garagam. So Raga Vardhini in the Sampurna is the Sampurnam would be the equivalent for Raga Chudamani in the Raga Padati.
Exactly. So it is very typical of Dikshitar. Only Dikshitar can get away with such weird prayogas like how we have
Shweta Ganapatim Vamadeva Pratipadyamanadhyam.
Such prayogas only Dikshitar can even attempt of doing. If he do such thing, it will be horrendous. Nobody can listen to it. What should be noted here is the Sampradaya Pradarshini doesn't give a verb in this Kriti. Usually all Dikshitar Kritis have verb. Like we have seen till now, Siddhi Vinayakam Anisham Chintayamyaham. I think of Siddhi Vinayaka. I pray Siddhi Vinayaka. Or let Ganapati protect me. We have some or other verb in Dikshitar's composition.
Shri
Ganesha Param Nahire Re Chitta. Or we are addressing it to our brain or to our chitta. There is some or other verb that is involved in the composition. This is one composition where there is no verb given in the Sampradaya Pradarshini. It should have been a serious miss out, or there should have been some other verb that maybe it was not documented, or maybe there were some more words in this. There was an extended version of this Kriti. We do not know where it has gone. Because it is in the Dvitiya Vibhakti, we can add the word Vande or Vandeham and sing it as
Shweta Ganapatim Vamadeva Pratipadyamanadhyam Shweta Ganapatim Vande.
You can see it as Shweta Ganapatim Vande. Should be some action that we are doing to Ganapati, or like Namaskaram or Vandeham, or Ganapati is doing to us, like protecting us or blessing us, something like that. Like Shri Kamalambikaya Kadakshitokam. Kamalambikaya, Kamalamba is blessing us with her glance, something like that. That being said, here is the word play of Dikshitar, how he has inserted the Raga Mudra of Raga Chudamani. He tells,
Matanga Mukham Vallabha Sametam Viraga Chudamani.
He tells, Viraga Chudamani. Raga doesn't refer only to melody. It also refers to affection or attachment to worldly pleasures or worldly desires. Viraga Chudamani. Chudamani is some precious gemstone that is attributed only to high individuals or to people of such great intellectual thinking or mahans, such great souls. the word Chudamani is attributed only to them. Like how we have Viveka Chudamani written by Adi Shankaracharya, that word Chudamani is given only to high realized souls. Here Mahaganapati, he is Vallabha's Netam, he has the goddess, he has the moon spouse on his lap. Who is hugging him, he is hugging her. They are always in connect with each other, but he is Viraga Chudamani. Even though they are physically connected, that connect doesn't affect his spiritual prabhavam or his anugraha or his his swaitara, how Dikshitar in his previous composition told swaitara vibarjitat, that swaitara is not affected just because his wife is there with him. He doesn't tell Raga Chudamani, he tells Viraga Chudamani. Even though his wife is there, he remains unaffected. Just like a droplet of water on a lotus leaf. Again, he proves the superiority of Ganapati. Ganapatya, again Adi Shankaracharya's influence. Every line, every aksharam, again and again he shows where his roots are, where his guru parampara are. He is so loyal to his gurus, so loyal, both his spiritual gurus and his musical gurus, very strongly affectionate towards Venkatamakhi and his school. Not even by mistake he has touched Karakara Priya or any other such, Chakra Baham or such ragams. His Sri Ragam is, it's only Sri Ragam. We will be seeing a very beautiful Sri Ragam coming up. So next we have, next, according to a Mudgala Purana, they give us 32 forms of Ganapati. Mudgala Purana is a very important text in the Ganapatya principle or Ganapatya form of worship or Ganapatya school. You can take it any way you want. They give 32 forms of Ganapati, which are divided into 16 and 16. I will just be going through the list of 32 forms of Ganapati and then we will be going into some interesting insights. First is Bala Ganapati, Taruna Ganapati, Bhakti Ganapati, Veera Ganapati, Shakti Ganapati, Dvija Ganapati, Siddha Ganapati, Uchishta Ganapati, Vigna Ganapati, Kshipra Ganapati, Heramba Ganapati, Lakshmi Ganapati, Mahaganapati, Vijaya Ganapati, Nritya Ganapati, Urdhva Ganapati. These form the first 16. The next 16 are Ekakshara Ganapati, Varada Ganapati, Trikshara Ganapati, Kshipra Prasada Ganapati, Haridra Ganapati, Ekadanta Ganapati, Srishti Ganapati, Uddanda Ganapati, Dvimukha Ganapati, Trimukha Ganapati, Simha Ganapati, Yoga Ganapati, Durga Ganapati and Sankatahara Ganapati. These are the 32 forms of Ganapati, of Lord Ganesha. There is a very prevalent concept amongst the Dikshitar's compositions that there are Shodasa Ganapati Krithis. According to what Mudgala Purana says and other Ganapatya texts says, the first 16 forms that I told, like Bala Ganapati, Taruna Ganapati, Bhakti Ganapati, Dikshitar should have composed on each of those forms. Each of those forms has a Dhyana Shloka, has a Yantra, has a specific puja procedure. There are many technical aspects involved in it. But that is not what Dikshitar has done. Shodasa Ganapati Krithis, we do not know how the concept has come up, but somehow it has come into vogue. There is nothing called as Shodasa Ganapati Krithis. Maybe you can take any 16 compositions of Dikshitar on Ganapati and call it Shodasa Ganapati Krithis. Out of all these 32 forms, Dikshitar has composed on a few forms of Ganapati. Like 3 or 4 forms maybe. But majority of the compositions have been attributed to Mahaganapati. Or the Ganapati that we usually pray to, the most common, the most accessible form of Ganapati, who doesn't require very difficult esoteric procedures. One such form of Ganapati is Heramba Ganapati. This Heramba Ganapati can be seen in the Tiruvarur temple complex. He is seen just beside Matavi Ganapati in the Praharam, when we go as Pradakshinam around Tyagaraja Swami. A very small vigraham, not much of lighting, not much of not much of importance is given in the temple to him in terms of lighting, lighting lamps or doing alankarams and all, but a very powerful form of Ganapati. Praying and worshipping this form of Ganapati is supposed to give so much of strength, physical, emotional and psychological strength to the devotee. He is also supposed to be blessed with all types of wealth and fame, yashas, as we call it. I will be reading the shloka, the dhyana shloka of this Heramba Ganapati, and then we will see how beautiful, how beautifully Dikshitar has said this song. Abhaya varada hastaha paasha dantakshamala shruni parashu danuhu mudgaram modakamscha phalam adhikata simha pancha matanga mukha pancha matanga vaktra ganapati rati gaura paatu herambha nama. This is the dhyana shlokam, or the shlokam that is used to meditate on Heramba Ganapati. Heramba Ganapati is seen with five faces, five elephant faces, and is seen with 10 hands, usually with 10 faces, as I already told. Each face has one separate color. The topmost face is pearl colored, whereas the other faces, there is one face on top and there are four faces in the bottom. The bottom faces are in gold, blue, white and red colors respectively. The topmost face is in pearl color. This form of Ganapati is very important and very important form of esoteric worship, and is seen in temples only where lots of spiritual energy is naturally invoked. Now in the shloka we saw Pancha Matanga Vaktra, which means the one who has five elephant faces. The Ganapati's form is frozen in the form of a Dhyana Shloka. If the Dhyana Shloka moved with a musical and a Tala form, it would be a Dikshitar's composition. The phrase Pancha Matanga Bhaktra takes a beautiful Malahari and it becomes Pancha Matanga Mukha Ganapati in Malahari Ragam in Tishra Ekadantam. Why he has chosen Malahari for this is another beautiful concept that we can think about. It's a concept that I came up with. I don't know if it is true or not. Something that was provoking for me, and I thought I could share with you. Malahari is the Audava Shadava Raga. There are five notes in the ascent and six notes in the descent. Ganapati has five faces. And so Dikshitar has chosen the Malahari. Why he has chosen Malahari and another aspect as six faces is, the sixth face can be taken as a Simha, or the lion's face on which Ganapati is seated. And so is Malahari.
Sari ma padasa Sada Pama Gadisa.
Before we move on to the concept of the Kriti, or listening to the Kriti, I thought I would brief on some more aspects of this Kriti. Dikshitar addresses Ganapati as Sumukhena in this Kriti. This is again in third Vibhakti, I guess.
Third.
Why Sumukhena? Sumukha is the one who has a pleasant face, glowing face, very pleasing to look at. But Ganapati, if a person sees Ganapati for the first time, he would be a bit hesitant to look at him. Because Ganapati has an elephant face, a huge pot-bellied human body, weird number of hands, a rat, a lion. This Ganapati doesn't ride a rat, he rides an elephant, he rides a lion. So there are so many elements associated with this godhead. Person seeing Ganapati for the first time will be shocked to see such a form of godhead. But Dikshitar here calls Ganapati a Sukhen. Is it? It is not just the physical form of the Godhead, but it is the Tattva or the unending or the undying aspect of Ganapati that shines all over Tiruvarur that made Dikshitar compose such a beautiful piece in Manahari. Another beautiful thing in this concept is usually Heramba Ganapati is supposed to be in white color. That's why in the shloka itself I told Gaura Pati Heramba Nama. Even though Ganapati has his five faces, as children you would have played with the color wheel. How many ever colors are there in the color wheel? If we move it around, it would turn white. The same thing with the prism. The small crystal prism, it passes through white light, becomes all colors. Again, Dikshitar proves that he is the Shri Vidya Upasaka through colors, Varna, all those concepts he again brings in again and again and again. Even though there are five faces with this Ganapati, he goes back to the Dhyana Shloka and of Padu Heramba and calls him as the one who is white in color in the Charanam. He tells Gaura Tarene, Karunardra Gauna Tarene. That is a beautiful phrase where Ardra means to become wet, means the wetness or moistness. Ganapati is moist with Karuna. Not of sweating. Tiruvaru is a hot place, but he's not sweating there. He's moist because of the Karuna which is flowing from all of his five faces. In all five directions. And then the Raga Mudra is very beautifully inserted here. And Kshetra Mudra is again given here as Kamalapura Viharena. And now we will listen to Panchamatanga Mukha Ganapati in Malahari Ragam.
Panchamatanga Mukha Ganapati Paripalitoham. Panchamatanga Mukha Ganapati Paripalitoham. Sukhena Shri Panchamatanga Mukha Ganapati Paripalitoham. Sumukhena Shri Pancha Matanga Mukha Ganapatena Paripalitoham. Pancha Bhutatmaka Prapanchodaya Pancha Bhutatmaka Prapanchodayadi Karana Vidinchi Hari Rudra Nudena Pancha Vakra Shiva Sudena Pancha Matanga Mukha Ganavatena Pancha Bhutatmaka Prapanchodayadi Chodayadi Karana Vidinchi Hari Rudra Nudena Pancha Vakra Shiva Sudena Pancha Matanga Mukha Ganapatena Paripalito Aham. Varada Bhaya Pasha Shreni Kapana Dhanu Mudakamudaraksha Mala Dharena Varada Bhaya Pasha Shrini Kapayana Dhanta Mudakamudaraksha Mala Dharena Kamala Pura Viharena Purubhuta Adhyakhila Deva Pujita Vigneshwarena Kamala Pura Viharena Purubhuta Adhyakhila Deva Pujita
Paripalitoham.
There are two, three more aspects in this Kriti that you can see now. He tells Puruhutadi Akhila Devata Devata Pujitena or Deva Pujitena. Puruhuta refers to Indra. Indraadi Devargal or Indra and other Devatas or Devi gods come and worship Ganapati. This might sound very common, like everybody worships Ganapati, so does all Devatas. But this is a Kshetra Kriti, as Dikshitar told Kamalapura Viharena and then told Puruhuta Dakita. As many of them know, Tiruvarur stands special for the Sayankala Puja or Sayarakshai, as it is called in Tamil. It is believed that all the Devatas come there to witness the grandeur of the Puja and lose themselves in the beauty of Tyagaraja there. So he also refers to the Puja ritual that happens every evening in that phrase. He very beautifully incorporates that. Only this may sound very, not very important to a student or a musician while learning, but only when we go to the temple, experience the puja procedures and other procedures that happen in the temple, and know the Kshetra Thala Purana, the Kshetra Visesha, we come to know all these beautiful insights that Dikshitar is giving and opens every single door in that about the Kshetra. Another is the Raga Mudra. It tells Kali Mala Harana Chaturena. Again about Tiruvarur he tells. Tiruvarur is a Kshetram where Kali Purusha or the badness or the evil aspects of Kali or the Kali Yuga cannot enter. The Kali Purusha cannot enter Tiruvarur. Or the Bhaktas of Tyagesha, wherever they are, this Hairamba Ganapati will protect them by Kali Mala Harana Chaturena. The Mala is unwanted desires or unwanted things that we have within us. Harana Chaturena. He removes that. In removing that, he is an amazing person. He is very intelligent. Kali Mala Harana Chaturena.
In fact, Malahari Raga is also that Malahara Iti Malahari.
Malahari. That Kali Mala Harana, that Mala Harana becomes is the Raga Mudra for Malahari. Again in the Madhyama Kala he tells Pancha Vaktra Shiva Sutena. Again and again he tells Pancha Matanga Mukha Ganapati. He goes back to the Dhyana Shlokam again and again. And in the Charanam, we have very beautifully referenced just the Dhyana Shlokam is given to us in a musical format. Even if the person doesn't know the Dhyana Shlokam of Hairamba Ganapati, if he knows this song, he would be able to identify Hairamba Ganapati wherever he sees him. Be in a painting shop or in Mahabalipuram, if he goes and sees some sculpture shop. Wherever he is, he would be able to say, this is Mahaganapati. How do you know? He has learned the Charanam somewhere way long back in his music class. Or maybe with some understanding that should be there.
Hello.
the Madhyama Kara Varna is three.
Varada Bhaya Pashashrini Kapala Danta Modaka Mudaraksha Mara.
I'll go back to the Jnana Shlokam. Abhaya Varada Hastaha
Varada Bhaya
Pasha Dantaksha Mara
Pasha
Shruni Pasha Danuhu Mudgaram Modakam Sjat
Pasha Shreni Kapala Danta Modaka Mudaraksha Mara.
Phalam Adigata Simha Panchamatanga Bhaktraha Ganapati Rati Gaura Patu He Rambhanam. I have already told about the Gaura, the white color of him, and He Rambhanam. He holds in his hand many ayudhas, Varadha Abhaya, Varadha and Abhaya Hastas, to protect his devotees. He holds a pasha, a rope, and he holds a shrini, a kind of an ankusha, kapala. Kapala is self-explanatory, a skull. Danta, as you already told, Ekadantam Bhajeham, he holds his danta. Modaka, a sweet. You know, all know of Modaka. Very dear to Ganapati. Modaka. Mudgara Akshamala, he holds a japamala or akshamala. Why is it called akshamala or akshanamala? Is because each bead of that mala has akaranti, kshakaranta, all the letters in it. He is the embodiment of supreme knowledge. So that is what he denotes by holding the akshamala. Not only Ganapati, but any godhead. Even Goddess Saraswati holds the akshamala. That is, that Dikshitar also, Heramba Ganapati is also a giver of supreme knowledge, is what is conveyed here. Kamalapura viharena puruvidhartakila deva pujitena vigneshwarena. He removes all the vignas or the obstacles that come in front of the devotee. Now we will move on to another composition. This composition reminds every music rasika of the duo Vrinda and Uta. Everybody would have heard at least their rendition once singing this Kriti. And I don't think anybody can do justice to the way they sing this raga or this Kriti. There are, I think, one or two more compositions in this raga. And I think it would have all been inspiration from the Dikshitar. Or they might be Sahakara composers also. I am not aware of that. The composition is Hasti Vadanaya Namastubhyam. In Raga, Navaroz. Till now, what all compositions we have seen, the ragas, like Chamaram, be it Manahari, or Bilahari, or Natai, or whatever ragas we have seen now, Raga Chudamani, all are Sanskrit names. So it wouldn't have been much of a problem for Dikshitar to insert the raga names, even Ardhradeshi for that matter. So now, Navaroz, I don't know whether it is even an Indian language, because there are some texts that tell that this is a Persian raga, like Sindhu Bhairavi. It's a Parashika raga, like Sindhu Bhairavi, Sahana, and all. There are a few people who tell that these ragas have come from Persia or as a part of the cultural exchange that took place between India and those regions. So Dikshitar has given a raga mudra in this composition, which is nobody can even imagine of inserting a non-Indian language raga name in an Indian language composition. This is Hasti Vadanaya Namastubhyam. In this composition, Dikshitar portrays Ganapati as Raja, not as Raja, as Maharaja, as an emperor ruling the world. He tells, Hataka Maya Mantape Simhasana Sthithaya. He is sitting in a mantapa made of gold and silver and whatnot of all the Navaratnas. In that mantapa, there is a simhasana or a throne on which Ganapati is sitting. He is not sitting alone. He is obviously sitting with his wife, Vallabha. And then a very beautiful aspect of Mahaganapati Dhyana, again Dikshitar proves he is a Sri Vidya Upasaka. I need not tell it, I am forced to tell it again and again, but because Dikshitar does that every time in his compositions. The Mahaganapati Dhyana, who are aware of it, will be aware of it. I wouldn't like to elaborate on it, as it is best to receive it from a guru. Few things are to be received only from a guru, only then it will sustain in our minds. So in this, very, very beautifully, we need the Raga Bhava. The Raga is so beautifully portrayed to show that Mandapa, that beautiful royal Simhasana scene as Ganapati with Mahaganapati, which is wife Pallabhamma. This is also supposed to be a Kshetra Kriti, Tiruvaru Kshetra Kriti. We see Mahaganapati or Vallabha Ganapati in a small niche just before we enter the Tyagaraja Swami Sannadhi in Tiruvaru. Many compositions, be it Mahaganapati Mande in Todi, Vallabha Nayakasya in Begada, many such compositions, even Mahaganapati in Nattai. That is also supposed to be in Tiruvaru, but there is another contradictory factor that Mahaganapati in Nattai is supposed to be on Ganapati Agraharam. So that is another beautiful aspect that we will do a little later on. But this Hasti Vadanaya exactly tells about how Ganapati is in that niche. Not even one detail is left unattended. So after he sings one round of the Charanam, I will make him sing another round of Charanam to explain how beautifully there are many other things in this Kriti. Now first let us listen to Hasti Vadanaya in Navaros Ragam, Vishwa Chakudar.
Hasti Vadanaya Namastubhyam Hasti Vadanaya Namastubhyam Hatakamaya Mandape Simhasana Sthitaya Sthivadanaya Namastubhyam Hatakamaya Mandape Simhasana Sthitaya Hasti Vadanaya Namastubhyam Hasti Kriti Vasana Dharachita Maha Ganapaya Tattva Swarupaya Samasta Bhakta Anugrahaya Maya Lingita Vigrahaya Samasta Bhakta Anugrahaya Maya Lingita Vigrahaya Hasti Vadanaya Namaya Tubhyam Kamalo Pala Pashashankar Chakrekshu Kamukha Vriyagra Gada Nita Vishadaya Matulam Ratna Kanasha Dharana Karamujaya Padai Pankajaya Vimana Vishwopati Sthiti Vilaya Karuna Alaya Himadritanayanana Pankaja Hiranyaga Bhaya Sumanase Uma Ramana Kumara Purubuga Samana Varojase Marase Himadritanayanana Pankaja Hiranyaga Bhaya Sumanase Uma Ramana Kumara Purubuga Samana Varojase Marase Stivada Naya Namastubhyam Hatakamaya Mandape Simhasana Sthitaya Sthivadanaya Namastubhyam.
This is a beautiful composition, as you would have heard. And those who don't know, Navroz, this raga, is a janya or derivative of Raga Shankara Abhinam. Subrahma Dikshitar, in his Sampradaya Pradarshini, beautifully gives the Raga Lakshanam. Details, it should be only from Panchamam to Panchamam. And only the top Panchamams can be used only in limited spaces, only in few instances. So it is very pleasant on ears, on our ears to listen, and even for musicians to sing. Yeah, it requires quite a lot of practice to sing such rare ragas. But once we get a hold of the raga, it's very pleasant, and we want to keep singing such pieces again and again. So let's get into the detailing of this kriti. He tells in the Anupallavi, Maha Ganapaya Tattva Swarupaya. Again, he loves tattvas, Dikshitar. Maha Ganapaya Tattva Swarupaya Ganapati. He goes again to Adi Shankara, his inspiration. I can't stop myself from telling these things because Dikshitar resonates so much with Adi Shankara Charya. If Adi Shankara spoke, his echo will be Dikshitar.
Savash.
In the Charanam, he moves on to tell what all Mahaganapati holds in his hands. It is Kamala, that is lotus, Utpala, water lily, Pasha, the rope, Shankar, or the conch, Chakra, that is the discus, Vrihyagra, that is the grain paddy. Then there is Mathulanga, your previous composition. Bijapuram is pomegranate. There Dikshitar told Ganapati holds pomegranate. Here he tells Mathulanga. Mathulanga is usually attributed to a citrus variety, smaller varieties. So it is again the root of all these species. In biological term also, that is the root. Ganapati is also root for everything. Again, Paradi, Chatvari, Vakatmaka. He is a Muladhara Chakra. He is the root for everything. How much there is similarity in what Dikshitar tells? Again, Vishvotpatti, Sthiti, Vilayaya. Utpatti, there is creation, sustenance, and dissolution. Shrishti, Sthiti, Samharam. Everything in Ganapati's hands. He sees Ganapati as Paradbrahma. Again, Ganapati. Beauty lies in the Madhyama Kalam of this.
హిమాద్రితనయానన పంకజ హిరణ్యగర్భాయ సుమనసే ఉమా రమణ కుమార గురుగుహ సమాన పరౌజసే మరసే కుమార గురు గుహ సమాన వరౌజసే మరసే.
The last two lines with this beautiful insights. Umaramana Kumara Guruguha Samana Varojase Magase. Umaramanan, the one who is dear to Uma, is Ishvara, Parameshvara. His Kumara is Ganapati. Or Umaramana Kumara Guruguha. Or Umaramana Kumara. Guru Guha Samana. Dikshitar here doesn't see Guru Guha as Murugan or Subramanya. He sees himself. He sees the self-realization or the Sayujya Padani, the four forms of moksha. Guru Guha Samana Varojase Mahase. Guru Samana Varojase. Navarojase comes there as the Ragamudra. Samana Varojase is the Navarojase as the Ragamudra. And Guru Guha Samana Varojase as Guru Guha, I am that Parat Brahmam. Aham Brahmasmi Tattvam is beautifully, very, unless we go into the depths and, you know, see each word by word, we can't, I don't think it is understandable for us.
Probably on the Advaita side, I think this is the actual thing, because I have read in screen interpretations where it says Ma Ramana is Lord Shiva, Lord Shiva is Kumara, who is Guru Guha. Lord Vinayaka is equal to that Guru Guha in power and in being very Viram like. So Samana Varojase, one who is in equal to being brave as Guru Guha, because Guru Guha is the Senadhipati of Devas. So he is also very brave. So in bravery of Guru Guha, who is the Kumara of Ma Ramana, our Vinayaka is also very equal.
But I feel that is more of a literal translation of Sanskrit lyrics.
But in the Advaitam side,
this I feel is more of the, I feel Dikshitar Krithi's compositions, be it any Krithi, even the ones that are as small as having a Shamashti Charanam, have layered meanings. As I think each Krithi should have a minimum of 10 to 12 layers. And Krithi is as big as this, I don't know how many layers it should have. And I feel this is only scratching the surface. I don't know whether we are even doing, whether we are even reflecting what Dikshitar would have thought in his mind. So now as we draw close to the end of this lecture demonstration. We come to an end, as usual, with a very auspicious Shri Raga. As you would have noticed, we started off with Trivarur and we again come back to Trivarur to finish. We started with Shri Mahaganapati in Gaula. We moved on to Vatapi, which is again in Trivarur, or nearby Trivarur if you think it is nearby. Again, Siddhivinayakam, which can be attributed to a Kshetram, but Siddhivinayakam, I think it is our house as a Kshetram. Because every house we do Ganapati Puja on Varasiddhivinayaka Vrattam as Pilaya Chaturthi. So I think Siddhivinayakam in Chamaram is Kshetra Krithi, as every house as Kshetram of Ganapati. That is also Kshetra Krithi then. Then we moved outside Tiruvarur. To Madurai, Vaidheeswaran Kovil, Kocham Kumbakonam, Swami Manedan side to see Shweta Ganapati. Then we saw different forms of Ganapati shop. We saw two other forms of Ganapati who are not very familiar to us, familiar to some maybe. We saw Heramba Ganapati, who was again in Tiruvarur. Hasti Vadanayan Navaroz Mahaganapati, who is again in Tiruvarur. But these two compositions, be Panchamatra Namukha or Hasti Vadanaya, can be attributed to any of these two forms of Ganapati in any Kshetram. It is Dikshitar has composed it in Trivarur, but even it can be attributed to any Kshetram. But the end, the finish off with this beautiful piece, Muladhara, Shri Mooladhara Chakra Vinayaka in Shri Ragam, in Adhikaram. This is a very beautiful reflection of Tiruvarur on Mooladhara Chakra Ganapati. There is a very small, beautiful shrine of this Pillayar, this Ganapati, near the Anandeshwara Swami Sannadhi. If Anandeshwara Swami Sannadhi is one of the Panchalingams in Tiruvarur. And when we go around Anandeshwara and come as Pradakshanam, we see a small Ganapati. I don't think he is even given Abhishekam regularly or something. He is seen in a very beautiful slanting position, unlike the usual straight position. Under him is a serpent coin, which denotes the Kundalini. Tiruvarur itself being a Mooladhara Kshetram, it is Mooladharam. When Ganapati is worshipped and invoked, the Kundalini rises. And what we get is Anandam. That's why he is near the Anandeshwara Sannidhi. Anandeshwara Sannidhi. Who else other can Dikshitar can even think? Or what Bhagyam should Dikshitar have done to be born in Tiruvarur? And how fortunate we should have been done to get such compositions from our ancestors. In this composition, Dikshitar talks of the Yoga Shastram in which he was an exponent in. He was also an exponent in Yoga Shastram. He was exponent in many other Shastrams too. He was an exponent in Yoga Shastram as well. He gives very beautiful insights into Yoga Shastram, which I will be telling once he finishes rendering this Kriti, beautiful Shri Ragam Kriti.
Shri Mooladhara Chakra Vinayaka, Shri Mooladhara Chakra Vinayaka, Amulya Vara Pranayaka, Mula Jnana Shoka Vinayasaka, Mula Jnana Shoka Vinayasaka, Mula Kanda Mukti Pradayaka, Mula Kanda Mukti Pradayaka, Shri Mula Adhara Chakra Vinayaka, Amulya Vara Pradayaka, Sakali Krita Devari Deva, Sakali Krita Devari Deva Shabali Sarvajna Swabhava Prakati Krita Vaikari Swabhava Parabhava Prasiddha Gajagri Vikata Shat Shata Shwasadhikara Vichitakara Bhaktopakara, Vikata Shat Shata Shwasadhikara Vichitakara Bhaktopakara Akadanka Vibhaswara Vigneshwara Hara Guru Guha Sodaralam Dharmodara Akalanka Vibhaswara Vigneshwara Hara Guru Guha Sodara Lambodara Shri Mula Adhara Chakravinayaka Amulyavara
With a few insights into this Kriti and a Mangalam composition, we will wind up this lecture demonstration. In this Kriti fascinates me so much with the amount of depth it has. Maybe we should do a separate lecture on this Kriti some other time. If time permits and Ganapati does Anugraham, this will happen some other time. So I will just go on to tell the highlights of this Kriti. The first is Moola Kanda Mukti Pradayaka. Again, Moola Kanda, Dikshitar goes to the roots. The root chakra is Moola Dharam. Mooladhara, each chakra has an element associated with it. Mooladhara has earth, prithvi as its element. Tiruvarur is a prithvi kshetram, as it has Valmika Linga Swami, the prithvi lingam again. So Tiruvarur is a prithvi kshetram, again it is associated with Mooladhara chakram. Everything forms a beautiful interconnection of Parat Brahma Tattvams. Then we have Vikata Shatshata Swasadhikara. In each composition, there are more compositions of Ganapati. We have taken only limited compositions for this nature. Dikshitar in each composition talks of Ganapati as each element of nature. For instance, like how I told, Mooladhara Chakram is referred to as element earth. Here he tells Shatshata Swasadhikara. There are 600 breaths a human being takes in a day. That is what Yoga Shastra tells, that is what Dikshitar tells. So the Shvasa, Shvasa, Nishvasa, again Ajaba, again the Hamsadhvani Naga, again Dikshitar's, their family's treasure is Hamsadhvani, again the Tiruvarur's treasure is Hamsa, Ajaba Natanam, again the Shvasa Adhikara goes there. Again, why Swasa Adhikara only to this Mooladhara Chakra Ganapati? There are so many Ganapatis there in the temple. There again, we have Panchamatanga Mukha Ganapati. There is a beautiful Uchishta Ganapati in Kamadambal's shrine. We have not touched him in this lecture demonstration. There are many more Ganapatis in the temple. Why hasn't he used anywhere there? Because that Ajapa, once that self-realization happens, what we get is Ananda. And Ananda as a embodiment is Ishvara, is Anandeshvara. Just beside Anandeshvara is this Ganapati, Mooladhara Ganapati. Who else can think of such things to incorporate in a song?
Other than
Krishna, obviously. And Vichitrakara. Usually Ganapati, we see him in temples in a sitting form or standing form. Vichitrakara. His form itself is very different. Is slanting, sitting on a serpent snake. Kundalini is usually described as having 2.5 coils. That snake is also having 2.5 coils on which the Ganapati is seated. Just the Yoga Shastram, what is there in books, is just reflected as sculptures in that place, in that shrine. There are many more shrines in Tiruvarur temple complex itself, where what we see in books is just reflected as shrines. What we just get shocked and fascinated when we visit that place. Bhaktopakara, he helps his devotees in what? In their spiritual sadhana. Only when the Mooladhara Chakra gets activated, the Kundalini moves upwards. Other compositions, he talks about other nadis and all his experience in Yoga Shastram.
In fact,
he talks about Ida, Pingadi, Sushumna. How Devi travels through the Sushumna Nadi, how she grants us bliss in the Abhayamba Vibhakti, and what he tells us that.
60 Vibhakti.
Yeah. So, I think that should be doing brief justice on Sri Muladhara Chakra Vinayaka and the Sri Ragam itself is enough to melt us. And another beautiful musical aspect of this Kriti is usually Dikshitar's Sri Ragams have that beautiful prayogam.
Alpa prayogam.
Alpa prayogam. What is it written? Can you see?
So in various compositions they have
in most of the Sri Ragam compositions like Sri Varalakshmi Namastubhyam, Sri Kamalambike, Yagaraja Mahadvajaroha, Sri Abhyambike, all these compositions we find this prayogam once. That their school tells that Sri Ragam is the Aganga Raga or the parental raga. We don't have Karhara Priya. They tell that this prayogam can be used only once in a composition.
Alpa prayogam.
Alpa prayogam. But this composition, we don't know for what reason, doesn't have that prayogam. Maybe because I think maybe alpa prayogam is very alpa, that we want only Brahmananda, we don't want all these alpa things. There is so much of things in this, maybe we should definitely do another lecture on this. So, we have shortage of time, we are running late, we'll finish off with a Mangalam on Dikshitar's very, although Dikshitar has composed so much on Ganapati, he always calls himself, addresses as Guru Guha Janani to Ambani, his favorite deity, be it Kamalamba or Kamakshi or Meenakshi for that matter. So we come to an end, we draw to a conclusion with a Mangalam in Raga Vasanta. If you ask me whether this Mangalam is really composed by Dikshitar, we do not have any proofs. If you know, please let us know. It will add to our research and we will work on it. As of I know, I am very unsure of the authorship of this composition that we are going to see. It is a very beautiful, a very peppy piece that that keeps audience glued and very beautiful piece. So he will sing and we will wind up our lecture demonstration with this piece.
Mangalam Jaya Mangalam, Mangalam Jaya Mangalam, Mamavaraja Matangi Jaya Jaya Mangalam Jaya Mangalam, Mamavaraja Matangi Jaya Jaya Mangalam, Mamavaraja Matangi Jaya Jaya Mangalam, Jaya Mangalam. Gangadhara Yuvati Parameshwari Mangala Varadayini Jagadishwari. Gangadhara Yuvati Parameshwari Mangala Varadayaki Jagadishwari. Sankatanashini Jaya Mangalam, Sadguru Guha Janani Jaya Mangalam, Sankatanashini Jaya Mangalam, Sadguru Guha Janani Shubha Mangalam, Jaya Mangalam, Mamavaraja Matangi Jaya Jaya Mangalam, Mangalam Jaya Mangalam.
This was a humble attempt. This was a humble attempt to present Dikshitar's composition on Ganapati, how he viewed Ganapati, and his insights to us on Ganapati. There are many more compositions on Ganapati. Dikshitar's authority on Vegavahini. There are many Vegavahini compositions. Saveri is there. There is Ramakriya Uchishta Ganapatau. There are many more compositions. But due to time and many other factors keeping in mind, we have restricted our presentation to 9 compositions today, and maybe we will do another part, a second part on this, on the same topic. So with that, we come to an end. We offer this presentation as a humble offering to the feet of Kyagesha, Kamalamba, Shri Mahaganapati and Muthuswami Dikshitar. Namaskaram. Guru Guho Jayati Jayati.